Good morning. So today I am continuing with Snippet Pixie next development. We were in the middle of doing database migrations, setting all that up for when people are migrating from older versions of Snippet Pixie up. With a couple of migrations we already have, and now we've got a new one as well. So think we were in stage here. So what we've done so far is we've handled the case of coming in and we don't have any snippets tables or whatever yet. Then we up add the settings table that came in version 1.5, and the slight change to the snippets to add a last used field. And now we're at the point of needing to work out how to migrate, how to update the table to use a UUID, which is how I want to do things going forward. Which is interesting because do I need to do that? I think I do. Because the plan is that at some point we'll have better syncing between different machines. And having a UID means that if you update the same snippet, you'll hopefully be able to update that same thing across instances a little bit easier. So yeah, I think we'll stick with the UID idea. However, that does cause us a little bit of a problem because I'm pretty sure in SQLite, which is the underlying database for the desktop, you can't just do migrations that easily. Yep, I think what we'll have to do is create a new table. And then for every snippet, grab it, stuff it in the new table, and then drop the old table and rename the new one. Now that's assuming we can do renaming and all that kind of stuff in SQLite. I think you can, but it's pretty complete. Hello. Thank you. Auto table. Got a drop table. Okay, but no. Can it do rename? There we go, yeah. Okay. I can do all the things now. Interesting. So I can do it either in place or as a new table. I think for safety, the new table route is probably best. Yeah, because you have to add columns and stuff anyway. You can't add, you can't auto existing. That's right. That's the difference. You can't auto an existing column. So, yeah, definitely need to go the new and switch. Which is fine, that's just safe. Just takes a little bit of work. Okay. But it'll be worth it, I'm sure. So. So here. Changed here. Okay. We're going to basically be doing not really that, actually. We'll take that as the basis. So, we'll just call it 60 for the moment. Let's put some comments in here. That's fine, isn't it? Did I get? I got rid of my Oh, I got rid of the initial setup. That's a shame. Didn't do that. I didn't leave anything in the test, did I? No. That's what I wanted. I could have copied a bunch of stuff from there. Oh well. Okay. So we're now back to that, and we want a last used timestamp. Won't do the index just yet. We'll do that in a minute. So create table. UUID snippets. I do keep wondering whether I should just use the abbreviation, but I think it might get a little bit dodgy if you're making changes in two different places to the same snippet. If you change the abbreviation or add another one, a duplicate with the same abbreviation, how do you? I'll just swap them out. That's going to be interesting actually, trying to work that out. So okay, so that in theory will do the job there. Just put the tail stuff in here. So now we need to do this. We need to query the existing ones and upgrade them. So, query equals. Oops. Yeah, I have to do this manually at the moment because my existing database functions are using UUID. So yeah, select from snippets. We're gonna do ID. Okay. What do you do there? Oh, caps lock. ID abbreviation body last used. I don't need to worry about my order anymore. So one thing we could do here. Thinking about what form I want to do this. Okay, this. Yeah, I'm going to take. Let's just do it all in line, I think. So what we'll do is we'll do some of this, but we're going to need a bunch of this as well. Just take that and I'll just chop it up in a minute. This is going to get really messy now. But we'll get there. So, could do that. Now we need to, right, we don't want that. What we need to do So if we've created that table. Definitely gonna be easier if I do a function here. Otherwise, I have to use like a. I don't even know if Go's got a go to and label type deal. Let's not go there. Func. No. Migrate snippets. UUID. I'll stick with manager for the moment, but I don't really need to use that. We'll see. We're going to return a slice of snippets with correct format now. Might as well make that a pointer. And hey, why didn't I do a point on the other one? And there might be an error. So now we need basically all of this. In here. Need to return snippets. All I need to do is just whack them into the table that we've already created. So here we're fine. Here something has gone horribly wrong. So here we're in trouble. We can't use just snippets here. So let's just do the bare minimum here. Abbreviation. Body. Last used. Time. Just need to wipe this back down to just single variables. If it all goes horribly wrong, just make that slightly different message so I can find it if I need to. And then we actually need to do the work. So this I'll get rid of that. We want to take here. Start a transaction. Hopefully that doesn't interfere with the rows. Presumably not. We'll soon see, I guess. So We're going to generate a new UUID. Actually, let's just call it UUID. And then turn that. Why is I complaining about shadowing? Presumably it's complaining. Don't really care. Don't need to do the last used. In fact, oops. We don't care about the ID. At this point, all we want is the data. The IDs are going away. So, abbreviation body last viewed is all the data we've got. Grab the ID. Got a new ID, we're going to use that, insert it. If we have an issue, hopefully I'll log back. I'll have to do that, won't I? Honestly, don't care. Transaction commit. That means it's all good. So in theory, come in here, select all the existing snippets. If we have an error, if it's empty, don't care, just return nil, we're good. Otherwise, return the error, get the data, start a transaction, Abbreviation body last used. Create a new UUID. I wonder, if I do this, will I get rid of all those warnings? What's going on with my keyboard today? I'm trying a slightly different way of holding my hands. I'm trying to do it. I've never been a proper typist. It's all self-learned. I'm trying to use the right method now. It's difficult. Slow going. I'm still wrong. Keyboard's at the wrong angle and everything. But, something a bit slower, but hey. Right, so enter and send snippets, do the thing. We're good. All right, so I think that's okay now. Migrate snippets to UUID. I should probably give that a little migrate snippets to UUID takes. Switches integer indeed snippets to use instead. Although it's not really temp, but that's fine. Better English. If we're here, we've moved everything across. So in trouble. Maybe we'll do might have to do some sort of backup thing before that at some point. later on. We'll see. Okay, we're good there. Then table. Can I use two? Ah, more coffee. Okay, yeah, it's not going to like that. How do I tell it? Not to worry. I might have to live with that little red line forever. Okay, in theory, that means it's done. Bar from. Add in back this. Yeah. Oh, I know, I can get rid of that. Think. Nice try, though. Oh, well. Right, talk to table UID, rename to snippets, do the thing. Create the table. Migrate. Put back the index. After the drop, update the schema version. Done. All right. Now the only issue we've got, apart from running out of time, is the tests, because they're going to be a mess now, because we don't don't have init schema anymore. Which is a real shame. I really should have kept that. Would have been handy here. Yep, I'm out of time. Okay, so my to-dos for next time to do create init schema. Tests. And create init schema. Functions. We're testing different schema versions. Okay. That's the other thing I need to do, is I need to not only create a quickly scaffold up a database with the current version, but I need to also create versions of the old schema and make sure I can migrate them as well. Yeah. I might backtrack on the removal of that init schema at some point, because there's a bunch of work being done here. Although, I suppose the daemon only comes up. The whole point of the daemon is to do this once and not be in the database lots of times and checking out stuff. You'll bring it up once, connect to it, give it a quick check, and we're done. And you only do that when you log in for the first time, whenever. Yes. Maybe it's not so hard there, because it is gated by the version. So next time, it's all about the testing then, making sure that the database migration works before I can then actually move on to creating a daemon that talks to it and a CLI that talks to the daemon. I think that's the plan for the next new bit of work after sorting out those tests. So until next time, thanks for watching. Take care.